have loved. I have been in love. I have survived and suffered in love. I have thrived in love. I have been there. So say many of the people in this world. Yet love is a very commonly mistreated word. It is a word that we throw around without an understanding of what it really means. It is today groaning under the pressure of expectation. So when I listen to my clients suffer in love, I wonder, is love a noun or a verb? Years of conditioning, what we have learned from our surroundings, our parents, as we were growing up, has made love look like a verb. It is a doing word. If you love me, this is what you must do. If you love me, you must marry me. If you love me, you must leave your family. If you love me, you must leave your job. If you love me, you must not take this. If you love me, and the list goes on and on. We've all done that. Each one of us. Think about it. In reality, love is a feeling. It is a sensation. It is not really conditional. If someone loves someone, maybe there's nothing to do. Maybe there's no action chart. Maybe there's no call to action. But our instinct of possessing a body, someone to come home to, a piece of their lives. Well, maybe the person can give it, maybe the person cannot give it. Love is not conditional. Love is not about, if you love me, this must happen or this must not happen. If he loved me enough, he would have left wherever he is right now and come back to me. If he loved me, he wouldn't have or would have. There is so much of condition on love. Love is actually just a rose blooming. I know it sounds philosophical and you may say that, are you trying to tell me that if people love us, they should not do anything for us or we should have no expectations in love? I'm actually saying nothing of the sort. I'm just telling you, people who cry themselves to sleep every night and people who suffer in love, ask yourselves this question. Is love causing all of this or is your expectation causing all of this? The expectation not only of the person to be a certain way, but also the situation to be in a certain way. My marriage should be like this. My lover should be like this. My wife should be like this. My girlfriend should be like this. So it's tremendous pressure either on the person to become somebody that he's not or she's not, or on the situation to be ideal. Well, I really love my husband, but if he had more money. So where does love go? What does love have to do with what you want? Love is an emotion. Love does not make us suffer. We suffer because of our own expectations towards either a person or a situation where in reality, and I tell my clients all the time, nobody owes us anything, anything. Including the ones we love and the ones who love us. So is love a noun or is love a verb? Everything else that we want to do for someone out of love, the feeling, the emotion, is something that we want to do voluntarily, not because love comes with a big baggage. And some of it is responsibility for sure. But don't mix love with responsibility, don't mix love with ego, don't mix love with how good it makes you feel. You know why we want people to love us? Why we want to hear them go on and on praising us? And why we feel really crestfallen when that doesn't happen? Because the truth is that we don't love our own selves. Our self-esteem, our sense of self is measured by how other people see us. And that is why we suffer. If we only learned that we are worthy just because of who we are, we would stop expecting in love. What are we expecting in love? For the other person to cuddle us, love us, kiss us, praise us, tell us every day how beautiful we are and how wonderful we are, or to show us through gestures. We are dipping into somebody else's energy field to get energy. But actually the source of energy is the universe. It is not another person. And people who go relationship after relationship looking for love attract broken people because they themselves are broken. It is just the law of attraction. So if you know people who are struggling in relationships, marriages, and cannot seem to find people who love them, please tell them that it is because they don't love themselves. They don't have a sense of their own worth, a sense of their own value, which is actually derived from being in love with your own self. Pull it from the universe. Plug your charger into the universe. Don't plug it into another human being. Nobody owes us anything. Not praise, not cuddling. Make yourself that energy that when others are around you, they love you. They feel that love. You know, it's not the love for their love for you. They are catching on to the vibration of your love with you. A baby is in love with itself. When we go close to babies, don't we just want to cuddle them and we say, oh my God, he's so cute, I love him. Why? Because the baby already is full of love and you are dipping into his energy field to take some of it. Why don't we all become love instead of looking for love? Why don't we become our own lovers first? So that not only your partner, but everyone around you, your children, your colleagues, everyone can be love. Be that energy of love that everyone can dip into. So is love a verb or a noun? I would love to hear from you.